Students, welcome to Shoudhav Sir classes. In today's video, we'll be solving question number 5, 6, 7 and 8 from the model question paper of SAT examination. So these questions are from the model question paper of SAT examination of section 3. In this section, for solving these questions, you can't use the calculator. As you can see here, the calculator is crossed. So that means you can't use the calculator for solving these questions. First, we will solve question number 5. If 5 by x is equals to 15 by x plus 20, what will be the value of x by 5? So 5 by x is equals to 15 divided by x plus 20. Now, if we cross multiply this equation, 5x plus 100 becomes equals to 15x. So 15x minus 5x, that is 10x, is equals to 100, which means x is equals to 100 divided by 10 or 10. So x by 5 will be equals to 10 divided by 5. So 10 divided by 5 is 2. Option C is correct for question number 5. Next question. For next question, different color of pen. 2x minus 3y is equals to minus 14 and 3x minus 2y is equals to minus 6. If x and y is the solution to the system of equation above, what will be the value of x minus y? So for finding the value of x minus y, we have to solve the given set of equations. So 2x minus 3y is equals to minus 14. This is our equation number 1, and 3x minus 2y is equals to minus 6. This is our equation number 2. Now, if we multiply the first equation with 3 and the second equation with 2 and then subtract the first equation from the second equation or the second equation from the first equation, we will see that the x component gets removed. gets cancelled. So first, if we multiply the first equation with 3, it becomes 6x minus 9y is equals to minus 42. And the second equation, multiplying with the second equation with 2, it becomes 6x minus 4y is equals to minus 12. Now, if we subtract the equation, the double of the equation 2 from the triple of the equation 1, we will get 6x and 6x will be cancelled out. So this one will be minus and minus, this will be plus. So minus 9y plus 4y will be equals to minus 5y. Similarly, this will also be plus. So minus 42 plus 12 is equals to minus of 30. So minus and minus sign from both the sides will be cancelled out. And y will become 30 divided by 5, which is equals to 6. So the value of y is 6. Now, putting the value of y in any of these two equations, we can easily get the value of x. The value of x will be equals to minus 14 plus 3y divided by 2 from the first equation. So minus 14 plus 3y, 3 into 6, that is 18, divided by 2 will be equals to 4 divided by 2, which is equals to 2. So the value of x is 2 and the value of y is 6. The difference between x and y, that is x minus y, will be 2 minus 6 or minus 4. So minus 4 is our correct answer for question number 6. Option C, minus 4. Now we'll solve the question number 7. But before solving the question number 7, I will first clear the page. Question number 7, there is a table of x and function of x. When x takes the value 0, the function of x becomes 3. When x takes the value 2, function of x becomes 1. When x takes 4, the function of x is 0. And when the value of x is 5, the function of x is minus 2. So which of the following must be a factor of function of x? You have to say among the following options, which one of the following must be a factor of function of x? So function of x, so to be a function of x, sorry, to be a factor of function of x, the value f of that value should be equals to 0. So f of x has to be equals to 0 at that point. So here from the table we can see that at x equals to 4, so f of x at x equals to 4 gives us the value 0. So we can say that at x equals to 4, function of x is equals to 0. So x minus 4 is a factor of the given function, as at x equals to 4, function of x gives us a result of 0. So x minus 4 must be a factor of function of x. Hence option C is correct for question number 7. Option C. Last question for this video, question number 8. The line y equals to kx plus 4, where k is the constant, is graphed in the xy plane. If the line contains points C, D, where C is not equals to 0 and D is also not equals to 0, what is the slope of the line in terms of C and D? So the equation of the line, or the linear equation, is y equals to kx plus 4 is in the slope intercept from. This is the slope portion and the plus 4 is the intercept portion. And so the slope of the line is k here, because we know that y is equals to mx plus c. This is the form of a slope intercept. So this is a slope intercept form of a given equation. So y equals to mx plus c, here the value of m is k, or the slope of the line is k. Since the line contains the point c, d, the coordinates of the point satisfy the given equation y equals to kx plus 4. So we can put the value of this point, the locus of this point c, d, in the given equation y equals to kx plus 4, and the equation will become d equals to kc plus 4. D equals to kc plus 4. Solving this equation, we will be able to get the value of k. The value of k will be d minus 4 divided by c. D minus 4 divided by c. D minus 4 divided by c is our first option. Hence, option A is correct for question number 8. So we have solved question number 5, 6, 7 and 8 in this video. In the next few videos, we will be solving more questions from section 3 and section 4 of this module paper. So if you have any doubt or any queries, you can call us in this number 9836793076, or you can send us email at showrupsirclasses@gmail.com. Thank you. Stay tuned for watching more videos.